Well, just when you thought it was safe, the other one went away, and I fixed it, but now we get its ugly cousin, another Vantage bass guitar, VS600B. Let me try and decipher that. VS stands for Very Shitty $60 Oh Boy. I don't know.
So I will make this right, but what I had to do with the other one is because these guys were just, I don't know what happened. Maybe they couldn't get a bridge that matched the radius of the fingerboard, but it's the same thing, and I'll go through it with you, and it's just like, it makes bass-like tones. There's no way you could play this and actually make music that was in tune with anybody else, because that string, I push it like that, and this one, it's like, so you'd get, some fingers would get muscles and the others wouldn't. I don't know what the hell they were thinking.
So I've just started. I haven't touched anything. I haven't adjusted anything. I'm just looking at what we got, what we don't have, which is a huge proportion of this episode anyway. So just see how bent the neck is, right? And it's bent, and I can look at it with my eyeball, and it's bent, so we got to make sure that straightens out, and we'll go under the VS600B name tag. Okay, the string height thing. Alright, I'll try and get this in the camera. You see the radius on that? It's not even anything close to the radius of the fingerboard. And because it's locked in time, you can't move the saddles up and down. It is just, it's a workout. Right? It's like a rowing machine. No fun at all. And then I can see where I get this too, like the other part too is, you see the route that they put into the body to sort of make this go somewhere where it might play, but it bottoms out and it doesn't work. Pretty funny, actually. Very frustrating on many levels, but okay, so we'll just pick a fret, the 17th fret, okay? The E string, the string action is 7 64s. We go 8 64s, you can do the math, that's just ridiculous. The A string is 8, 9, 10, 11. This one is 11 or 12, and then we get down to this G string, which is almost where it could be to play the bass at 5. So I'm just going to loosen the strings. I'm going to put this down as low as it goes, and we'll see how. Well, no, I know. I'm going to make sure that the truss rod works, and then we'll fiddle with this thing. Once again, fooled by the bling. Fooled by the fact that, wow, that looks really good. It's, you know, look at the finish. Look at that looks good. That should be good, right? Looks good. You know? Wow. It's gotta be good. Come on. Look at it. It looks good. And then let's go for a test drive. Let's go buy a used car at night, right? Let's go for a test drive on a sunny day. I don't know. Doesn't look like any human has ever been in there. And knowing from where it comes from, it's going to be a 5 mil. All right. Loosen the strings a little bit. Well, just let's see if it turns. It turns beautifully. Look at that. Smoothie. No crunching, no clicking, no cracking. There's hope. Okay. We managed to straighten out the neck. I went where no human had ever gone before. Now we're going to look at the string action. Pick a number, pick a fret. Okay, now that I straightened out the neck, it's almost right, but I'm going to dunk this right to the bottom. Not to the bottom. I'm going to get the... See, the E string's almost right. The G string is too low, and these are just ridiculous. It's like you can see it. The A and the D string are a mile higher than the other two strings, and there's no way to get it right. Good luck to the guy who was trying to learn bass on this thing. Okay, so when we bottom the bridge out, to see what we don't have, we have an E string that would be exactly where I'd put it. We've got, okay, so that's 5/64, maybe a hair above 5. This, the A string is now at 8. The D string is at 8, and the G string is too low. This is going to make the others jump up even higher. Okay. Surgery is required. So when I set the outer two strings to something that's usable, I mean, pick a number. I'm using what I love, which is 5/64. Now the D string is 9/64. And the A string is 9/64. So this is just a whole design mess. It just would never work. They didn't care if it worked. They just sold them. And here we are. You know, like, this is a cool little bass, but I can't play this. You'd be all out of tune, pushing the other strings harder than the others. It's just ergonomically sad. And we gotta fix it. So what I did last time, and I'm just gonna forego the nonsense, I took the saddle out. Do that right now because they fall out. It's not a great engineering feat to take that out of there. It's number 3. So I belt sanded a bit off the bottom best I could, because this slot, what happens is it gets so deep, the file hits the sides before we get as deep as we want to get. Oh, goodness. Stick that back in there. So we'll get maybe a 32nd by taking some off the bottom. And then we'll have to do the rest with a slotting file. Okay. I got down and dirty with the belt sander. Why is my light not on? Oh, something's wrong again. My goodness. Freaking gremlins and... Goodness. Goodness, goodness. Is there any goodness in the world? Okay, that's beautiful. That is still sitting. Wow, we gotta do a lot of carving. We got a lot of carving to do. So much material has to be removed from that nut slot that you can't do it well, it's in the bridge because there's nothing holding anything together. So you have to take it all apart, take it out, make your best guess. I can measure it. I sort of scribed a line in there, but and a few hundred strokes later, I know I got a long way to go. I'm not scared about tweaking anything till I get it back in the guitar. But this is just not friendly metal. Yeah! No, I'm not even close.
Right, so now we're going to reinstall it. Reconnect the A-string. Maybe. Stupidest string attachment ever.
Is it going to pop out and hit me in the face? Oh, farting noise is my favorite. Really? Let's see what my guesstimation turned out to be. Looks kind of good. I'm getting there. I'm getting closer to something that'll play. So, we're sitting pretty there. Oh, 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 that's bad. Not even close.
Okay, the E and A string are the right height. Can you see where the D string is now? Can you see that? Sorry for the camera work, but it's just like, you can't, it's like, wow, what happened here, and who decided they were going to not fix this?
Just wanted to get another angle of this, right? So, we're good. That's been corrected. This is what they sold. And that string needs to be down there somewhere so that it matches the curve of this. Then it'll play, and you won't be banging your face against a brick surface. I think I'm down to it. I can already, you know, guess what the comments are. Well, why, how, no, see, the thing is, there's no benchmark here. This is all art, not crafts. Once I get it close, I have to go at it a little bit at a time. What happens if I go too far and cut one of these too low? Now what do I do? Well, that means I have to cut all those lower and raise everything. So aren't I the donkey? Right now, the string action. That is pretty skookum, I'd say. That's a technical term. See, now I can play it. What's that vibration? It could work. This one actually, compared to the other one, the neck bridge alignment thing isn't as wacky as the last one I had. So it's really, it's more proud brother than the other one. You know, it's like a family. When you have kids, they all sort of turn out a little differently. They're all good, mind you. They're all wonderful children. But in the end, you know, there's a couple that just... I'm not saying you're stupid. I'm just saying you have bad luck when it comes to thinking. So I'm just going to go over this one more time. Make sure the neck is straight the way we like it. And I don't know, it seemed to got creaked back. I want to loosen that. Just a little bit. I'll be right back. We're rocking. Except for, please don't send me your dust. Keep your dust and dirt at your house. Oh, I guess I gotta open that up and do another job. You're going to need everything. Busted again, you're busted again. Copyright strike. Kiss my grits. I didn't play the whole song. Oh goodness. Okay, I it's as good as I can make it. Oh, I gotta open that up. We'll play with that. Like all the things you guys really want to see. Dave inside a cavity. Dave opens a cavity. Back to things that are coming down the pipe. I got some cool stuff to look at and marvel over. Suction pig. Don't leave home without it. Oh, a little deoxit D5. And both controls. Spin them around a few hundred times. Plug it back in. Oh, shit! They all work. And it plays, like I can play each string without fighting the other string. It's actually not bad, now that we fixed this, but you know. Don't be disadvantaged by your Vantage. What can I say? All the links are below. Somehow PayPal has decided to change their interface, so the links that they told me to make that say what to do don't seem to work anymore. I'll reinvestigate that. And, you know, my account with the tax agency here in Canada apparently has been hacked. Like, what's left to hack? There's nothing. I got nothing left to hack. So I got a big notification about that today, about my whole identity has been, they call it revoked. My whole login has been revoked. We've shut you down, and you can try again and make a new identity because we think the other one was compromised, but we weren't hacked. We just maybe know, what are they talking about? You know, that's it. Just log into a government website, you'll be fine. Right? All right, yeah, anyway, the links are below. If you want a sticker, it's $8 US, shipping included worldwide. Penny Black CD, $22 US, shipping included worldwide. You can become a patron and pay whatever you like, or not pay at all. You can become a free member of the Facebook group. Just don't be a dick. You can subscribe and be a dick if you like, because no one cares. What else? You can Twitter me. I don't read those very much, but you can try. Once in a while, I look. Once a week, tweet, tweet, tweet. And what's left? You can be good to each other and be safe. Cheers, folks.